Today we'll talk about the tips and the lessons I've learned over my 7 years of swing trading. In Bangkok, where all the shops are closed because of the virus, we took a boat and came to this place that's like really far, but it seems cool, so we'll have lunch and I'll bring you guys around to see what the real local Bangkok looks like today. They sell bread near the piers in the water just for the fish. It's like 20 baht, which is like less than 80 cents for a big pack of like 10 something bread, and you can buy and feed the fish. It's nice. But these are the things that just you learn for fun. These are things that I actually apply myself to be able to make more money over time, and I'll share this with you in no particular order, just apply them. And I'm pretty sure if you swing trade right now, you're going to see a big difference in your result. So let's start right now with the first one. My first tip that I learned quite recently, I would say, about like maybe 2 years ago, is looking at the chart at least 3 or 4 times per day, minimum. If you want to swing trade, you got to be looking at your chart frequently. And that doesn't mean like always being there and refreshing your chart all the time and try to watch your trade unfold all the time. It's not the case, but at least look at your charts 3 to 4 times per day. And that will give you more clarity, not just to like spot trades, but that's one part, being able to spot the right trades. But it's also about being able to kind of remembering the market in your mind, what's happening on every pair. Like right now, because I look at the chart myself every day for a few times, I know what pairs is doing what. I know USD CAD is in an uptrend. I know USD is in a range that is doing nothing there. And I know, for example, that AUD JPY is in a downtrend. All of this because I look at the chart a few times a day, and I remember everything. Now, it doesn't mean that I'll look at the chart and will place trades every time I look at the chart, but it's just to create a mental picture in my mind so that if I were to enter a trade quickly, I know what's happening everywhere and I can enter a trade really fast, and that's really good. So that's my first tip, looking at the chart 3 or 4 times per day minimum. The second tip is being able to identify the turning points in the markets. These points where price is likely to reverse. And that's something you can do like partly with support and resistance areas, like people teach online, that's part of it. But the other part is your experience in the market. Like the more you see the charts, the more your brain gets used to it, the better you are at like spotting the points where price is likely to reverse. And that's something that comes over time. So you can try to learn from people who've done it before. You can try to watch my videos where I talk about this in depth, or you can just try it yourself and try to see on a certain pair what kind of points are likely to make a reversal in the market, or what particular point on the chart of this pair is likely to make it continue a trend or breakout or whatever. You can spot these things really well if you're used to it and if you spend time to look at the chart over and over again and actually like spot differences. Maybe make a journal where you keep track of things, of how you will implement things. Maybe make a journal where you will keep track of things and what you want to like look at and what you notice. And that's going to make a big difference. Lesson number three, or tip number three, is about systems versus prediction. Now, for the longest time myself, I was all about prediction, predicting the market. And I know a lot of you guys watching this are. You want to predict where this pair is going to be because that makes you feel good. It's for your ego to tell people that you know what you're doing. But that is all crap. That doesn't work well in trading. If you want to make money, you got to be spending time working on your systems and not your prediction. That's going to make the biggest difference. Like think about people that are making a living out of trading. Most people, they actually have systems that they follow all the time. They have systems for trades, they have systems for journaling, they have systems for everything. And you want to do the same thing. So whenever you find yourself in a market, in something you look at like a pair, you apply your system, not your prediction. And that's going to make the biggest difference. So for me, I've been over time systemizing now everything. And all my trades, they happen like automatically with systems. And even if I enter them manually, it's all about me who knows what I need to execute. It's not about like what I think will happen, but what my system tells me to do. And that makes the biggest difference too. So if your system is at on point now, you can work on that, you can improve it for sure. And if you fail in the market, it's not about yourself. Most of the time, it's about your systems. And if you have no system, then make one. That's gonna make a big difference. Tip number four makes all the difference as well, is to find out when things don't work out. When are things not likely to work out for a pair, for a market, for a specific trend, or whatever that is. But try to find out, like, when is it that your setup fails? And most people don't wanna do that because they think, oh, my system is so good, I wanna keep doing the system, I know it's gonna work. But find out where the system is likely to fail. That's a tough exercise, but it will make a big difference. Find out where things don't work well. And that, even though you will see your system fail, and that's gonna feel bad, at least you know where to stop trading it, and at least you know when it's not gonna work out well. And then you can actually act on that and stop trading when it doesn't work well, or stop trading in these times where it's not likely to work well, and your result will be better, okay? So tough thing to do for sure, but it's gonna make a big difference. And tip number five is about using your stop loss to create for yourself a better mindset and better result. So back a few years ago, I learned online through different mentors that you had to use like a 2-to-1 reward to risk. So I used that for my trade. I didn't think about it twice. I just use that all the time. And that's good, but that's only like a half solution. It's not like the whole thing you want to use for your trades. So what happened with this is that, yes, you have 2-to-1. So the premise is that by having a 2-to-1 reward to risk, you can win less often and still make money. And that's all good. But I found out that this wasn't good for my mindset at first and for my result, because I was doubting myself when I would take trades. I was closing my trades too early. I was also leaving profit on the table quite often, and that's not good for anyone. So eventually I learned this principle of adjusting my stop loss and moving into break even, and then eventually having two trades, closing half the trade and letting the other trade run further. And that made a huge difference in my mindset, because right there, I felt better when entering a trade, because I know the only thing I had to do basically was to get the trade to 1-to-1 of reward to risk, so 1 times the stop loss, and then I would take half the trade and I would be safe after that. And then I would just let the trade run, and if it were to come back to a loss, I would still be fine, no issue with that. And so that made a big difference for me, to be able to use my stop loss or use my trade management to be able to not feel bad and to improve my mindset. And eventually, of course, I felt better with that, and I could eventually go to the point where I did not need that stop loss to break even. I could just trade with a 2-to-1 reward to risk, or even a 3-to-1, and I felt good because I'd seen the result before. But if you are starting out right now and you have no idea what you're doing and you just want to be safe in your trades, or you want to improve your mindset that's been hurt before, then having that stop loss that you move to break even makes a huge difference. And ultimately, your result will be better, your mindset's going to be better. So that's all that counts. Now, I want to hear from you guys in the comment section, so please comment below in the comment section and let me know what tip would you apply, or what other tip have you gotten before that you want to apply in order to swing trade better. You can leave anything you want in the comment and I'll look at them and reply to them as always. So here are a few comments for the past video. I appreciate your comment always, you guys. You can comment below and I'll answer those whenever I can. As always, if you want to get more help from me, you can check out the academy we have. We help people get really good results and eventually quit their job from trading. The link is going to be in the description for that, so check that out. And I look forward to working with you guys on one-on-one pretty soon. Ciao.